Hello everyone, and welcome to another Unity tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to export a video from Unity with transparent background. I'm going to use Unity Recorder for that. So if you are not familiar with this tool, I highly recommend checking out our tutorial on Unity Recorder first, before proceeding to this one. The link is in the description below. Let me start by saying that at the time this video is recorded, there is no intuitive way to capture a video or a GIF with a transparent background in Unity. I hope Unity will add that feature later on, but at the meantime, I will show you the workaround that I found. There are basically two steps to it. First, we will capture a sequence of still images with a transparent background from Unity, and then we will create a GIF or a video in another application. I will show you how to do that in Photoshop, and in case you don't have access to Photoshop, I will show you another way to create a GIF file for free. Let's go to our scene in Unity and create a new camera. Clicking on Game Object menu and selecting Camera option. A new camera appears in the scene. Next, let's change the parameters of the camera so that it matches our main camera setup. I'm changing the projection to orthographic because that's the camera that I'm using normally, adjusting the position and setting the Z value to -10 so that it shows our scene properly. Great! Now we're going to configure what exactly this camera is going to capture. Currently it captures everything we have in the scene, but I want to capture only the marching vegetables and without any background. To do that, let's change the culling mask to nothing. This will uncheck all options. And then, let's change the culling mask once again and choose the veggies layer. I've placed all my vegetables object in the veggies layer, so that's exactly what we need. You can select multiple layers to capture if you like. Now, I don't want this new camera to interfere with the main gameplay camera. So, let's change the camera depth to -2. Now you can see that in the camera preview, there are only margin vegetables, and in the game preview, we see our normal scene with the background. Awesome! One last setting for this camera is to assign a tag to it. Let's create a new tag and call it GIF Camera. Then, let's go back to our new camera and assign this tag to it. Great! Now, let's proceed to the recorder settings. Please make sure you have Unity Recorder package installed. I'm going to Window, General, Recorder, Recorder Window. Let's click Add New Recorders and select Image Sequence option. I'm changing the format to PNG and a new option, Capture Alpha, appears. Alpha is just another name for transparency, so that's exactly what we need. Currently, it is grayed out, but we will make it accessible later on. Let's set the path to where we want the images to be saved. I recommend creating a separate folder for that, so that these images will not mix with the rest of your recordings. Awesome! Then, let's change the capture settings and select Targeted Camera option. In the source, let's choose Tagged Camera and type GIF Camera as a tag. This is how the recorder knows what exactly should be captured. Make sure you change the output resolution because otherwise you will get small images in the size of the game preview. I'll choose HD 720p for my image sequence, but you can choose any of the options available. Please keep in mind that the higher the resolution, the longer it will take to capture and process the images. And now, as you can see, Capture Alpha option has become available, so make sure you check this checkbox. Great! We are ready to record the images, so I'm clicking Start Recording button. The recording starts immediately, and you can see the number of frames captured here below. Click Stop Recording once you've finished capturing what you need. All the images that you've recorded will appear under the folder that you've created. Currently, it is just a series of separate frames, and we're going to make a video file or a GIF out of them. First, let me show you how to do that in Photoshop. If you don't have Photoshop, don't worry. I will be showing another free tool that you can use later on in this video. In Photoshop, you need to create a new file matching the height and width of your images. Then, select all the images that you have and just drag them into this Photoshop file. Each image should appear as a new layer. Then, once all the frames are loaded, go to Window, Timeline, and press Create Frame Animation button. Right after that, hit the small menu icon and select Make Frames from Layers option. Awesome! Now each layer or each image that we've recorded is a frame. If you'll hit Play button, you'll see this animation playing. Now let's go ahead and export it as a video. I'm going to File menu, Export, Render Video. In the Render Video window, make sure you change the format to QuickTime and change the Alpha Channel option to Straight and Matted. Then just hit Render, and after a couple of seconds, you'll have a video file with a transparent background. Now, if you want to export this animation as a GIF, just go to File, Export, Save for Web, Legacy. A new window will pop up. Here you can change the number of colors and other quality settings and preview the animation again. I'll just click Save, and after a number of seconds, I'll have a GIF file ready. Now, in case you don't have Photoshop, here is another way to create a GIF file. I'm using an online tool called GIFmaker.me. It's easy, it's free, and it doesn't require a registration. You just go to this website, click Upload Images, select all the images by pressing Ctrl+A, and click Open. Wait until all the images are uploaded, and then the animation preview should appear in the Control Panel section on the right. Here you can change the animation speed. 30 milliseconds look just about right to me. And then just click Create GIF Animation button. It will take some time to generate a GIF file for you, but once it's done, a number of options will appear. You will be able to preview your GIF, download it, or delete your images from this tool. And in the end, you get a smooth GIF animation that you can use to showcase your work. That brings us to the end of this tutorial. If you found it useful, then give it a like and share it with your friends. If you'd like to see more tutorials from us, please make sure you subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.